to the Greater Kitchener-Waterloo Chamber of Commerce Business Excellence Awards Gala presented by Cowan Insurance Group. Thank you all for being here tonight. Before we get started, I want to take a moment to acknowledge that we live and work on the traditional territory of the Neutral, Anishinaabe, and Haudenosaunee peoples as we seek through them a renewed relationship based on the foundation of mutual understanding and respect. As participants in today's virtual event, we're coming together as one. We believe everyone is fair to be their true self and receive the same respect and opportunity regardless of age, ethnicity, gender, culture, identity, sexual orientation, beliefs, or language. We hope you'll join us in fostering a positive environment here tonight to ensure a safe and welcoming space for all. The Chamber recognizes there is more to do and are committed to listening, learning, and growing. And we're still not back, of course, to having everyone in person this evening. However, we do have more than 300 people here at Binghamton's tonight, plus close to 400 more joining us virtually to celebrate the incredible businesses we have here in Waterloo Region. We are all very fortunate to call Waterloo Region home. We are diverse. We drive a culture of innovation. We're home to world-renowned companies, exceptional post-secondary institutions, state-of-the-art research centers, and startups, as well as successful businesses. Now, we're constantly growing, but as we evolve, we manage to maintain that real sense of community. We've all learned a lot over the past couple of years. Businesses in our region really demonstrated an entrepreneurial spirit of resilience, innovation, and adaptability among the business community. And there are so many local success stories to highlight as well, and have had a real global impact. So we're thrilled to highlight several of them this evening as we hand out 14 awards. Tonight we will celebrate our award winners, but we do want to recognize all of this year's nominees. Our judges poured through submissions and had the privilege of learning more about the nominees and their accomplishments. All nominees should be extremely proud. Now, these businesses are the reason Waterloo Region is and will continue to be a center for success. Of course, this evening would not be possible without continued support and the generosity of our incredible sponsors. They continue to support the many economic and community development programs that the Chamber offers. So please hold your applause until all of the sponsors have been acknowledged. This evening's title sponsor is Cowan Insurance Group. They have always been a strong Chamber supporter and a leader in innovation and entrepreneurship here in Waterloo Region. Year after year, their partnership continues to make this evening so spectacular. Sun Life is our reception sponsor this evening. We hope you all enjoyed yourself at the reception tonight, whether you attended live in person or virtually. Our nominee after party is sponsored by BMO Financial Group. Thank you for providing our nominees with a wonderful after party to celebrate all of the incredible accomplishments. Thank you to Grant Thornton for being this evening's toast sponsor. The celebratory champagne for our winners, also courtesy of Grant Thornton. Our ambiance sponsor this evening is Reed's Heritage Homes. Thank you for sponsoring the centerpieces for our live attendees and providing a virtual photo booth. Now, for those attending virtually, don't forget to share your photos using the hashtag BEAGala for a chance to win a $150 gift card to a salon or spa of your choosing. McCarter Grespin is our celebration sponsor who helped to make it possible to provide some pre-show entertainment for our virtual guests and the wine for live guests here tonight. BDO Canada LLP is our generous gift sponsor. They have once again made a generous donation as part of this evening's event. I would like to welcome Kim Southern, partner of BDO Canada LLP, to the stage to tell us more about their donation.
Where do I see if my camera's on and is my mute off? Okay. Haven't done this in a little while, so I'm a little out of practice. But on behalf of the partners of BDO, we're happy to sponsor the gift tonight. But as has been our tradition for the last several years, there's more important things going on in the world than providing trinkets at the table for everyone to take home. So 50% of our gift sponsorship tonight is going to help to support Indigenous peoples, and the other 50% will go to humanitarian aid for the people of Ukraine. So we're very we're very thrilled to try to give that back, and hopefully we can challenge the rest of the companies out here in the audience to do the same. Thank you very much.
Video Canada, LLP, has also generously arranged a prize for two lucky guests this evening. So we're going to be awarding each guest with an overnight stay at the Walper Hotel, plus a welcome gift and dinner at TWH Social to support our local restaurant and hospitality industry. The two lucky winners were randomly selected. Those winners are Shelley Campanola, who is attending the event here live in person, and Scott Wagler, who is attending the event virtually. Congratulations to you both. A chamber rep is going to connect with the both of you so you can claim your prize. And thank you again to Video Canada LLP. Thank you to our gold sponsor, CIBC, and bronze sponsor, Waterloo EDC, for your continued support. Now, with the support of local media, we can keep our community informed on all of our members' accomplishments and new initiatives. Thank you to 98.5 CKWR, Waterloo Region Rural Post, the Coral Chorus Radio Group, 91.5 The Beat, and 107.5 Day Rock, Rogers Radio Group, 96.7 Chime FM, Country 106.7, and City News 570. And finally, Bell Media, including Bounce 99.5, 105.3 Virgin Radio, and CTV Kitchener. Although virtual, a lot of preparation and planning, of course, went into this beautiful event, so a special thank you to at MC Photography for the photography tonight, Bingaman's for hosting us here, and for the hospitality boxes that many of our virtual attendees are enjoying at home, Blitzen for the online award nomination management platform, Decor and More for transforming the room tonight into what really feels like a garden oasis, Sound Events for producing and streaming tonight's production, Token Creative Services for designing all the visuals and graphics leading up to and during tonight's event, Westmount Signs and Printing for providing the prestigious awards that our winners will receive and the event signage. And a special thank you to our performers for providing the live entertainment this evening, Mandipal Gandu, Isabella Hoops, and DJ Denim. We would also like to thank our corporate and municipal partners, as we recognize them, for generously investing in a critical chamber healthcare initiative that enables us to oversee programs throughout the year to attract new family physicians and serve the primary healthcare needs of our community. So please join me in thanking all of these incredible sponsors. We would also like to recognize the 2021-2022 Board of Directors who have helped guide the Chamber and support its members during yet another unprecedented year. Allison Burke, Oxford Learning, Waterloo. Wendy Campbell, the Food Bank of Waterloo Region. Carlene Carroll, Wilfrid Laurier University. Brad Dunbar, Getz and Dunbar Professional Corporation. Shelley Forwell, Walter Fady. Scott Gilfillan, PWC. Nick Hefner, Hefner Lexus and Hefner Toyota. Gina Huddle, Sun Life Financial. Richard Jakes, BMO Bank of Montreal. Ian McLean, Greater KW Chamber of Commerce. Ajua Minta, For All Ice Cream. Chris Ronan, Ronan Consulting. Adam Smith, My IT Guy Corp. Sean Sullivan, Gowling WLG. And Glenn Thorpe, Flight Path. So please join me once again in thanking these wonderful volunteers for all they do. So I would now like to invite Adam Smith, owner and CEO of My IT Guy and chair of the Board of Directors, to say a few words now.
Good evening, everyone. All right. This is weird. I've just been talking to a camera and like my teleprompter for 2 years, and now there's 300, 400 faces in front of me. This is super strange. So thank you for bearing with me while I figure this out. So first of all, on behalf of the Board of Directors, I want to extend our warmest and sincerest thanks to all of you for joining us this evening. This year's gala has over 600 business leaders, dignitaries, and community members in attendance. We appreciate all of your support as we recognize extraordinary businesses and members of our community. An event of this scale, especially running two events simultaneously, is no small feat. In addition to all of the incredible sponsors and partners who helped make this event possible, we would also like to thank the dedicated team of Chamber staff and volunteers. Special thanks to the Business Excellence Awards Committee, Jeff Collins, Scott Gilfillan, Leslie Heptich, Mike Hewitson, Nala Kaur, Mary Catherine Lorenz, Stephen McInnes, Curtis Montgomery, Beth Palmer, Michelle Tutman, and Committee Chair Laura Hewitson. Special thank you to Ian McLean and the dedicated chamber staff who helped organize tonight's event, including Lauren Ewan, Hannah Kelly, Riley Thompson, David Winger, Dana Walton, Jenna Petker, Heather Hutchings, Mari Reed, Carolyn Marsh, and the entire chamber team. This event is truly a team effort. I'd also like to extend an official welcome to the dignitaries and community members who are present this evening, including City of Kitchener Mayor Barry Verbanovic, City of Kitchener Mayor Dave Jaworski, Township of Woolwich Mayor Sandy Johns, Region of Waterloo Chair Karen Redman, MPP Catherine Fife, MP Mike Marius, and City of Waterloo Councillor Diane Freeman. Your support of this evening's event is greatly appreciated. Thank you all for being here with us this evening. Now, I am going to need your attention for this super important interactive part of the evening. Don't worry, I'm sure you're all going to pass with flying colors. Raise your hand if this is your first big event since March 2020. All right, audience participation, thank you. That's a lot of hands. So, raise your hand again if you're happy to see all these wonderful smiling faces around you. There we go, we got some excitement. One more. I lied, there's two more. Great to see some excitement in the room. Raise your hand if you're feeling awkward or out of place with your social skills. Where are my nerds at? Yeah, nerds! Thank you. I'm so glad I'm not the only one. This is so much better. And finally, a round of applause. If you just have to be out and here to celebrate the successes of our community, give me a round of applause. Thank you so much for that energy. That really helps. And is anyone else wondering, has Dean been wearing that kilt all 26 months on Zoom and we just didn't know? Looks great, by the way. As we lead up to the formal award presentation, I would like to congratulate this year's nominees on your outstanding accomplishments. You should all be exceptionally proud of the work you are doing and the difference you are making here in Waterloo Region. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Adam. Now I'd like to invite Adam Diamond, Regional Sales Manager, Vice President, Business Development Group Benefits with Cowan Insurance, to say a few words now.
I personally, this is my first night away from two kids that I've had since March 2020. So, round of applause for all the new parents the last 3 days. I'm honored to be here tonight on behalf of the Cowan Insurance Group to welcome you to the 2022 Greater Kitchener-Waterloo Chamber of Commerce Business Excellence Awards. Whether you're joining us from home or sitting in the room with us tonight, it's wonderful to see so many people here showing support for KW's local business community. Between the Blue Jays, the NFL Draft, the Raptors trying to force Game 7, and a new season of Selling Sunset on Netflix, there's a lot of competition for your attention. So we're thrilled to be here celebrating with all of you. We're proud to have partnered with the Chamber for over three decades, providing members with solutions that matter. We're always grateful to the Chamber for the opportunity to participate and support this great event. A company that treasures our local roots and relationships, it's essential for us to celebrate our local business community. We admire the Chamber's dedication to helping businesses grow and prosper, particularly over the last few years of turmoil, challenge, and unpredictability. Tonight, we come together to acknowledge and commemorate the invaluable contributions Chamber members make to our local community, economy, and families. People and organizations represented here tonight promote growth and excellence in the region of Waterloo, and we're so impressed with your leadership and unwavering commitment to your businesses. Congratulations to all of tonight's nominees. I scanned an impressive list of nominees across 14 incredible categories, and I'm honored that Cowan belongs to such an incredible community. I'd also like to congratulate everybody in attendance, both in person and virtually, for persisting through the challenges and continuing to deliver excellence. Your dedication is truly inspiring. So on behalf of Calum, thank you.
Thank you very much, Adam. I would now like to introduce Martha Breida, Partner Research and Development and Government Incentives Leader, Canada, with Grant Thornton. Martha will lead us in a toast, regardless of where you might be right now. I ask that you please stand and join me in raising a glass to welcome Martha.
Thank you so much, Alexandra. I appreciate that. So, good evening, everyone, and welcome. I will make this very quick. I've already timed it. It's a minute and a half, so just bear with me. So, we are here tonight to celebrate our extraordinary business leaders who are contributing to the vibrancy of our Kitchener-Waterloo business landscape every single day. My name is Martha Breidoff. I am so happy to be here with you tonight celebrating in person, as my family has a long history of business, community building, and public service in this region. My father, Jim Breidoff, was an elected MPP for Kitchener through 5 elections over 17 years, and our family has served as city councillors, judges, MPPs, and MPs since arriving in Berlin in 1861. I share this with you tonight as a reminder of the diverse founding fabric of our region that continues to prosper today, and the recognition of the massive potential that each and every one of us have as business leaders in shaping the future of our cities. I'm even luckier, though, tonight to be joined by my work family. Table 2, hey guys, wave. Thank you. They were prepped for that. My partners and I at Grant Thornton truly live our purpose and passion every day, which is to help our clients, colleagues, and communities in which we live and work thrive. As you know, Grant Thornton is an advisory firm that helps clients through everything from assets to exits, and so we recognize the tremendous accomplishments of these business leaders tonight. And so with that, please raise the glass to congratulate all of our nominees for the 2022 Kitchener-Waterloo Business Excellence Awards. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Martha. So before you take your seat, sorry, I know everyone is starting to sit down now. I just ask that you please remain standing for the singing of O Canada, performed by Alison Burke of Oxford Learning Waterloo. Thank you very much, Allison. Okay, it's now the time that we've all been waiting for, the announcement of nominees and recipients of the 2022 Business Excellence Awards. There will be 14 awards handed out tonight. The recipients of tonight's awards are chosen through a comprehensive award selection process following the call for nominations this past fall. Each nominee completed a nomination support package. The submission kits were then reviewed and analyzed, and judges made their final decisions. Some winners will be accepting their award live here on stage tonight at Binghamton's. However, several other winners who are attending virtually will be doing so remotely. Winners have all been kept confidential, only to be revealed live during tonight's show. And a reminder to our virtual attendees to be close to your computer when your category is called and announced, and to keep your cameras on so we can unmute you and provide you with the opportunity to accept your award from your remote location. So we're going to hope everyone's technology is on our side tonight. In the case, though, a winner is not able to accept their award, we're going to move on to the next category and just keep the show going. So let's get started. This evening's first presentation is for the Employee Engagement Award, sponsored by Conestoga College Institute of Technology and Advanced Learning. Introducing the award is VP of Finance and Corporate Services for Conestoga College, Jacinda Rietsma.
On behalf of Conestoga College, we are proud to sponsor the Employee Engagement Award. Nominees in this category have provided training to improve the skills, knowledge, safety, and performance of their workforce. They have reduced employment barriers and have increased productivity through innovative and creative programs or initiatives for their teams. This year's nominees are ABA Architects, Exonify, H2R Business Solutions, Highland Cannabis, MPE Consultants, Rees Informatica, Valco Team, and Wilfrid Laurier University.
Congratulations to the 2022 Employee Engagement Award winner, Exonify. As a training organization, providing opportunities to Exonifiers to learn and grow is top of mind. Exonify believes diversity adds richness to their culture and depth to their ideas. To reinforce awareness of bias in hiring decisions, they host an implicit bias training session for all leaders. The topics covered include microaggressions, unconscious bias, gender identity and expression, generational diversity, as well as privilege. Exonify increases productivity through their people-first approach to doing business, which is all about building a workplace that supports employees as human beings, not resources, and enables them to bring their best each day. I believe Exonify has a virtual watch party happening right now with their team, so I'd like to pass it over to Carol Lehman to accept the award.
Can everyone hear me? Thank you very, very much, Chamber. I am thrilled again to receive this honor on behalf of the team, and we have an excellent team of people who are highly engaged, and I couldn't be more grateful for the hard work that they've been doing always, but certainly through these last couple of years. So, thank you again for the recognition. I can't tell you how much we appreciate it, our employees appreciate it, and good luck to all the other nominees tonight as well.
Thank you very much, Carol, and congratulations again to Exonify. Next is the Volunteer of the Year Award, sponsored by Wilfrid Laurier University. Introducing the award is President and Vice Chancellor, Dr. Deborah McClatchy, and presenting the award is Assistant Vice President, External Relations, Carlene Carroll.
Thank you for that introduction. Wilfrid Laurier University is proud to sponsor this year's Volunteer of the Year Award. Volunteers are vital to the success of the Greater KW Chamber. There are over 100 dedicated volunteers who devote endless hours to serve on committees, assist in planning events, champion important issues, and donate their business expertise and resources to support the Chamber and its members. This award is presented to an outstanding individual who, in the past year, has demonstrated significant volunteer and event participation and has made exceptional contributions to their leadership, time, talent, and energy to Chamber initiatives and the greater Chamber community.
So a big congratulations to Steve Ashton. Steve Ashton has been a dedicated member of the Business After Five Committee for over 5 years. He is respected in his role of vice chair on the committee, but also well known in the Chamber community for his positive attitude and enthusiasm. A small business owner himself, Steve is constantly looking for ways to connect and support others. Steve strives to find new ways to help the Chamber grow and emphasizes the importance of giving back to our local community by supporting initiatives and nonprofits such as the Food Bank of Waterloo Region and Canadian Blood Services. In addition, Steve often lends his musical talents to various chamber events and the annual Business After Five holiday performance. The Greater Kitchener Waterloo Chamber of Commerce is honored to have volunteers like Steve to help support our members. So please join me in congratulating the 2022 Volunteer of the Year, Steve Ashton.
Thank you. I don't think anyone is more surprised at this than I am. So I'm absolutely honored and thrilled. So thank you to the Chamber. It's always a pleasure to see so many smiley faces and to see you all in person, and it's just fantastic. And the really cool thing is I get to share this night with my mom, who's in the back there. As soon as you said my name, she was like, "Who's Steven?" So, thank you for giving me that moment. Thank you very much.
Congratulations again, Steve, and a big thank you to all of the incredible Chamber volunteers, many of which are in attendance here live this evening. Our next presentation is the Environment and Sustainability Award, sponsored by Enbridge. Introducing the award is Marie Costello, Director, Southeast Region Operations with Enbridge.
On behalf of Enbridge, we are proud to sponsor the Environment and Sustainability Award once again this year. Nominees in this category have made an outstanding commitment to sustainable development and prioritize the preservation of the environment. They've taken action through self-initiated environmental practices and programs beyond legislative requirements and have provided environmental stewardship, education, and innovation. They are leaders in demonstrating impact and progress towards a sustainable future. And the nominees are AET Group, Arcadia Projects, Best for Bees, Borealis Grill and Bar, Change Lifestyle and Apparel, Earthscape, For All Ice Cream, Home Hardware Stores Limited, Joseph & Company, KEI, Paradis Environmental Consulting Inc., Smart Choice Electronic Recycling.
Big congratulations to AET Group. AET Group. AET Group embodied sustainability in all aspects of business operations to achieve their recent goal of net zero carbon across all operations by 2030. AET has publicly committed to water reduction, waste diversion, and greenhouse gas reduction as part of Sustainable Waterloo Region. Through their 1% for the Trees program, AET is planting trees through local and national organizations. To date, AET has planted over 6,700 trees through partnerships with the City of Kitchener, Wilfrid Laurier University, Mary Allen Neighborhood Association, Forests Ontario, Trees Canada, and Wild and Pine. This initiative has resulted in over 425,000 kilograms of carbon dioxide removed from the atmosphere, and leading to 585,000 kilograms of oxygen produced. Additionally, AET employees volunteer their time to educate the community on the value of trees and assisting in tree plantings. So please join me in welcoming Scott Freiberger, who is virtually accepting this award. As we mentioned at the beginning, there could be some technical issues. There's our first one right there. But still, a big congratulations to AET Group. Okay, so next we have the Nonprofit Charitable Award, sponsored by MTE Consultants, Inc. Introducing the award, Vice President Paul Eichinger.
Thank you for that introduction. On behalf of MTE, we are pleased to be sponsoring the Nonprofit Charitable Award. Nominees in this category are outstanding nonprofit or charitable organizations that have achieved excellence through innovative and proactive leadership. They have implemented initiatives resulting in significant and measurable outcomes and developed the skills, knowledge, and performance of this organization and volunteers. Nominees for the Nonprofit Charitable Award are Anishinaabeg Outreach, the Brain Injury Association of Waterloo-Wellington, Canadian Mental Health Association of Waterloo-Wellington, Coalition of Muslim Women of Kitchener-Waterloo, Compass Refugee Center, Hospice of Waterloo Region, Kitchener-Waterloo Community Foundation, KW Habilitation, One Roof Youth Services, Rare Charitable Research Reserve, Ronald McDonald House Charities, South Central Ontario, the Humane Society of Kitchener-Waterloo and Stratford-Perth, the Museum, United Way Waterloo Region Communities, Women That Give, and YMCA of Three Rivers.
Congratulations to Anishinaabeg Outreach. Anishinaabeg Outreach provides Indigenous people with culturally appropriate services and programs. They offer a centralized space for individuals to learn, grow, and become a beacon of hope for future generations. And they now offer virtual solutions. Anishinaabeg Outreach currently serves 25,000 Indigenous people each year. Over the past 3 years, they have grown by more than 1,000%. Starting with two staff members, they now have more than 25 and are currently recruiting an additional 20 full and part-time positions to support the development of a cloud-based learning management system that is accessible 24/7. This Anishinaabeg Outreach Nest will enable them to support up to an additional 250,000 Indigenous people nationwide. They are dedicated to fostering close personal relationships with volunteers and clients to ensure they are meeting the needs of all individuals. So please join me in welcoming Stephen Jackson to the stage to accept this award.
I actually think she said everything. So there's not much for me to say other than thank you. BDO, we're Indigenous, so if you want to do the journey to us, we accept that. My first day on the job was the worst ever. We lost all of our funding because we only serviced 8 Indigenous people. Last year it was 14,000. Next year I think it's going to be about 140,000. So for me, if you look back at table number 47, you'll see a bunch of women, really smart women, formidable, that literally move the needle. I looked around the room, a lot of guys, a lot of women. But I encourage you to embrace that talent because they move the needle. They achieve outcomes on reconciliation I can't even imagine. And I'm thrilled to work with them. The board, I say thank you, my chair, of course, and pretty much everyone that partners with us. Because through partnerships, that's how we achieve the outcomes. That and the team. So thank you.
Congratulations to Anishinaabeg Outreach. The next is the Service Excellence in Hospitality and Tourism Award, sponsored by Gowling WLG. Introducing the award is Bryce Craker, Waterloo Region Managing Partner of Gowling WLG.
Gowling WLG is proud to sponsor the Service Excellence in Hospitality and Tourism Award. The pandemic has had a devastating impact to these industries. But although these businesses were many of the first to be forced to close their doors and turn away guests, these organizations moved swiftly to mitigate the impact on their business. They reimagined the customer experience and have engaged with guests in new ways. This year's nominees have demonstrated a commitment to providing exceptional customer service and guest experiences in hospitality and tourism. By doing so, they have demonstrated measurable successes and are key players in increasing awareness of the Waterloo region. The nominees are Apollo Cinema, Canoeing the Grand, Center in the Square, Charcoal Steakhouse, Fresh Look Design, Janet Lynn's Bistro, Proof Kitchen and Lounge, S&V Uptown, The Grand Mathiel, The Grazing Table, and The Kitchener Market.
Congratulations to Canoeing the Grand. Canoeing the Grand was established 30 years ago with one man's vision and 8 canoes. Within 2 years, it became too much to manage and was sold to a second stakeholder. Continued growth has meant the addition of 61 more canoes, 65 kayaks, and 60 rafts. From the early days of drawing 1,000 guests per year to the KW area, Canoeing the Grand has grown to provide an experience to over 14,000 guests per season. Canoeing the Grand partners with other local hotels, museums, restaurants, camping areas, amusement parks, as well as festivals to create an optimal tourist experience and to draw visitors for more than just a day. During a difficult 2 years for the tourism industry, Canoeing the Grand has continued to seek growth, offering a safe and enjoyable outdoor experience for guests. Joining us virtually to accept the award is Shelley Jo Courtney.
It's speechless.
I didn't really prepare anything, honestly, because I didn't expect to win. I can't even tell you how grateful. I've reiterated how difficult this time has been for all of us as businesses, and I'm beyond grateful.
Congratulations once again to Canoeing the Grand. Well, next is the Innovation Award, sponsored by Scotiabank. Introducing the award is District Vice President for Waterloo Region, James Daneman.
Scotiabank is thrilled to be this year's sponsor of the Innovation Award. The pandemic changed the way many of us do business. It forced companies to shift their mindset and disrupt tested business practices. It served as a catalyst for innovation, with many great successes right here in our region. This year's Innovation Award nominees have created, invented, or developed an innovative product or process that has had a significant and measurable result. The innovation has resulted in an increase in revenue, job creation, productivity, quality, reduction of costs, and/or improvements in service. Congratulations to this year's nominees. A Friendlier Company. Apply Board. Cart to Curb. Chef D TV. eHealth Center of Excellence. Imitros. Food Bank of Waterloo Region.
Congratulations to eHealth Center of Excellence. In January 2020, eHealth Center of Excellence established a new division called ECE Automates, which is focused on the creation of automated solutions designed to enhance practice efficiencies and improve patient outcomes. Their automated solutions, or bots, are virtual assistants that can help healthcare professionals use, maintain, and securely circulate the data within different health information systems. The bots reduce the risk of clinician burnout by creating a more streamlined and efficient workflow with less tedious, repetitive tasks. And one particular success story was saving one family health team nearly 90 hours of time that would have been spent manually logging and reconciling patients' COVID-19 vaccinations. This past July, they also launched HEAL, Healthcare Experience and Advancement Lab, an immersive clinician experience lab that enables their team to work hands-on with healthcare providers to co-design the future of care delivery. From virtual care to AI, the eHealth team is leading healthcare into the future. Please join me in welcoming Ted Alexander to accept this award.
To the event sponsors and to Scotiabank for sponsoring the category. It's an honor to be nominated for innovation in the Kitchener-Waterloo area. I'd like to thank the ECE Automates division who stepped forward during the pandemic to create a product to help reduce clinician burnout. I specifically want to thank Justin Wolting and Kunal Kendra who are with me tonight. Finally, I want to thank clinicians. We're a member of the KW4 Ontario Health Team, and we work with a great group of clinicians that help us build solutions. And finally, I want to thank all clinicians in Ontario that who, while they were swabbing us and vaccinating us and caring for us, they let our bots go in and reduce some of the administrative burden in their medical records. So thanks everybody, and we'll see you again next year.
Congratulations, it's such a great example of a business really stepping up and supporting the community through innovation during such a time of need. Well, next is the Health and Wellness in the Workplace Awards, sponsored by Walter Fady. Introducing the award is Garth Crestman, CEO of Walter Fady.
On behalf of Walter Fady, we are proud to sponsor the Health and Wellness in the Workplace Award. Now, more than ever, wellness programs are evolving, and businesses are putting the employee well-being at the forefront. This year's nominees have achieved a healthy workplace and have provided strategies, initiatives, policies, and programs that promote, support, and enhance healthy workers and workplaces. They encourage healthy lifestyle, taking measures to support both physical and mental health. And the nominees are Accelerator Center, Alliance Global Assistance, KEI, Manulife, OCAS, Second Skin Society, and Volco Financial Limited.
Congratulations to Kuntz Electroplating Inc. through the efforts. Through the efforts of the KEI Wellness Committee, their employees and management team focuses on six dimensions: physical, social, sustainability, nutritional, psychological, emotional, intellectual, and spiritual. Through group and or individual activities, employees can get involved and win prizes or recognition throughout the year. They provide a dedicated health center on site with a full-time registered occupational health nurse providing health screenings and education around the benefits of exercise. KEI also offers mental health first aid training, wellness fairs, and a variety, active social clubs so they can offer their employees as well as their families a variety of experiences to maintain that work-life balance. They also prioritize financial wellness with an RRSP matching program, profit sharing opportunities to meet with financial advisors, and much more. In addition, they consistently offer challenges, yoga classes, varied lunch and learns, reflexology, massages, and more to encourage employees to explore new opportunities while at work. KEI's top priority remains the safety and well-being of their employees, and they believe that wellness is about adding years to life and life to years. Please join me in welcoming President Robert Koontz to the stage to accept this award.
I'll keep this quick, but this is a great honor, and we really appreciate it. Thank you very much. You know, over the years, we've come to acknowledge and realize that caring about the wellness and the health of employees and investing in various programs and initiatives to ensure that is one of the best investments, if not the best investment, that a company can make. So that's our philosophy. I want to thank my brother Dave, who's up here with me as well, our cousin Mike, who couldn't be here tonight, as well as my dad, Robert Kuntz, and our uncle Paul Kuntz. Every time we mention that we get choked up, who passed away a little over 10 years ago, and of course Oscar Kuntz, who started the company. But most of all of our employees and our staff, they're the ones that make our company possible, and they're the ones really deserve the applause. So thank you very much.
Congratulations once again. Our next award presentation, the Community Builder of the Year Award, sponsored by Hefner Lexus and Hefner Toyota. Presenting this award is Nick Hefner, Variable Operations Manager with Hefner Lexus and Hefner Toyota.
Hefner Lexus and Hefner Toyota are proud to sponsor the Community Builder of the Year Award. As one of our core values, we have been strong supporters of charities and projects in our community, and we are not alone. We are so fortunate to be surrounded by philanthropical community leaders and businesses, both big and small, who generously contribute to the community in which their employees live and work. This award recognizes a business who has demonstrated a willingness to make the community better by regularly supporting charitable or nonprofit organizations and practicing good corporate citizenship. They have a vision for a better community and have taken action to make it happen by promoting community betterment. Congratulations to this year's nominees. Ability at Work, Communitech, Digital Sabbath Film Company, Economical Insurance, Graham Matthew, HIP Developments, Huron Creek Developments, Kitchener-Waterloo Association of Realtors, Learners LLP, Libro Credit Union, Lyle S. Ballman Foundation, Morty's Pub, MTE, Token Creative Services, and Talk Dukes.
Congratulations to Morty's Pub. An integral part of the philosophy at Morty's Pub continues to be giving back to the community with an emphasis on supporting children. Hundreds of kids per week have full bellies and can achieve better focus on academics as well as extracurricular activities because of the Morty's Pub breakfast and food programs. Their partnership with the Waterloo Knights of Columbus also providing families with the opportunity to give their children gifts during the holiday season. Morty's Pub strongly believes that without community, no small business will succeed. Now more than ever, with decreasing government funding for community and social programs, they believe it is essential for businesses to give back. Restaurants are part of the backbone in any community, and a wide variety of restaurants help to introduce community members to new cultures and diversity altered food. To help promote this, Morty's Pub has supported other restaurants through active social media and marketing initiatives. Morty's also donated tables, chairs, and patio umbrellas to other restaurants throughout the pandemic so they could continue to operate and expand their own businesses. Joining us virtually to accept the award on behalf of Morty's Pub is Steve Campbell.
Sorry, give us a sec here. we don't know if you can hear us, but everyone, thank you so much. JT and I here, we've always considered Morty's Pub to be a community family room. We've been afforded the opportunity to meet people who want to give and make our community a better place. The reality is that Morty's is just a conduit, and we're happy that we're able to help match those more fortunate with different programs and people who need assistance. Without many of you, and without the support of our staff and guests, we wouldn't be the lucky recipients of this award. We're not in the trenches, and it's important that we recognize others that have helped build the programs that we support. People like Lisa Lewis and the staff at Lincoln Heights Public School, who administer and manage the Kids Breakfast Program. Kelly Sue Oberle from Food for Kids. Martin Hickey and everyone with the Knights of Columbus who manage the annual toy drive. We'd also like to thank these people that have always supported our asks for funding. People like Chris and Brian Tank and Steve Wilkie from Swan Dust Control, Paul Schmidt from Windmark, Steve Heimbecker from Heimbecker Mortgage Group. All these folks have donated to countless fundraising initiatives. Again, there are many more, but our time limit's almost up. Thank you again. This is such an honor to everyone who helped us get here. We promise that we'll continue to be community builders well into the future and we'll keep plugging away to help make KW a better place for everyone to live and thrive. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Congratulations, and thank you to the team at Morty's Pub for all you do in bettering our community. A great example of a small business making a large impact here in the region. Our next presentation is for the Young Professional of the Year Award, sponsored by PwC. Presenting the award is Scott Gilfling, partner with PwC.
On behalf of PwC, we're proud to sponsor this year's Young Professional of the Year Award and support these future leaders and trailblazers who are already reshaping the workplace. Nominees in this category are under the age of 40 and have tackled the challenges of entrepreneurship or have demonstrated professional growth and success in their respective field of work. These individuals have demonstrated corporate and community leadership. And the nominees are Adam Cole, the Prohibition Warehouse and Kentucky Bourbon and Barbecue, Waterloo; Alan Cayenne, Peak Realty Limited; Armin Bakertzian, Medical Innovation Exchange; Cecilia Johnson, Seafood Experience; Jennifer Saberis, Simplify Supply Chain Solutions, Inc.; Josh Gesowatsky, Ignite Group; Kaylee Dale, A Friendlier Company; Lindsay Coulter, Lindsay Coulter Photography; Maddie Campbell, Canadian Student Leadership Association; Mary Beth Kennedy, Highway Flowers; Mifra Abid, Coalition of Muslim Women of Kitchener-Waterloo; Shirley Liu, Kitchener Public Library; Spencer Nechakov, RBC; Terry Patrick, The Social Agent.
Congratulations to Armin Bakertzian, co-founder of Medical Innovation Exchange. Armin grew up in a medical household, which sparked his interest at an early age. During his undergrad at the University of Waterloo, he was able to combine his passion for technology and medicine in what became IntelliJoint Hip, the product of IntelliJoint Surgical. Now, once Armin was able to obtain a medical device license from Health Canada, he was able to commercialize IntelliJoint Hip. In 2016, they closed $11 million in Series A funding that they raised entirely in Canada. They celebrated 1,000 cases with IntelliJoint Hip in 2017 and have completed over 27,000 surgeries globally. In 2019, Armin founded the Medical Innovation Exchange, MIX, Canada's first industry-led hub for medical technology startups looking to scale and convert their prototypes into products. MIX is now a thriving domestic ecosystem of health innovation and commercialization with 5 resident companies, bringing tremendous benefit to the region and Canada by developing, sustaining, and retaining domestic medtech companies here, establishing Kitchener-Waterloo region as a leader in medical innovation. So please join me in welcoming Armin, who is joining us live tonight to accept this award.
Thank you so much. This is an extreme honor for me, especially amongst the class of phenomenal young professionals. Especially in this region, we have a habit of producing excellence at a young age, and it is an extreme honor for me to be here to accept this. Of course, I'm not here alone. It took an entire community and a village to build our company and to build our ecosystem. So a sincere thank you to everybody in this community, every single person that has helped me, has helped my team get to where we are today, and last but not least, my fantastic team. We are here because of you. Our successes are yours, and I wish everybody at our company and this community continued success into the future. Thank you so much.
Congratulations again to Armin and all of this year's young professional nominees. This next generation of trailblazers and thriving business leaders are innovative, ready to break barriers and take on top-concerning world issues. So our next presentation is for the new Business of the Year Award, sponsored by Bell. Presenting the award is Lena DeMarco, Regional Director of Community Relations for Bell.
Thank you for the introduction, and hello, everyone. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Kitchener-Waterloo Chamber for hosting this incredible event this evening, and for their ongoing partnership with Bell, and also for their support of the business community through these difficult times. On behalf of Bell, we are proud to sponsor the New Business of the Year Award. Nominees have been in operation for less than 2 years and have demonstrated innovative and proactive leadership within their industry. Additionally, they have significant measurable success, growth, or promise while practicing good corporate citizenship and promoting community betterment. The following new ventures are emerging strong despite the uncertain times. A Friendlier Company, Change Lifestyle and Apparel, The Etiquette Shop, Ginger Goat, Henson Shaving, and Medical Innovation Exchange.
A little whoops there, but congratulations to A Friendlier Company. A Friendlier Company is building a tech-driven, reusable packaging system to eliminate single-use food packaging waste. They provide food service businesses with high-quality, Ontario-made reusable packaging and facilitate the collection, washing, and sanitation, and then redistribution to create a closed-loop system. Since launching a year ago with three customers, they've grown the company to support over 60 brands across southwestern Ontario. Their team has also grown from 2 to 13 and raised over $500,000 in investments to drive their scale up across the province. A Friendlier Company is centered around sustainability and shifting the way people think about waste. They are women-founded and are building a diverse team, including 4 co-op students from the University of Waterloo. They've also added a feature on their platform that allows users to donate their deposits to charities to give back to the community. So please join me in welcoming co-founder Jackie Hutchings to accept this award.
Thank you very much. We were not expecting this at all. It's crazy to think that we just started out just over a year ago, and we've already grown to support now almost all of Ontario with our reusable packaging. We just surpassed over 100,000 containers reused, so we're very excited about that. I want to thank the Chamber and thank everyone who has used our packaging or all of our businesses that support us and offer reusable packaging. I want to thank our incredible team because we wouldn't be here without the amazing team that we have, and I'll pass it over to Rebecca.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for this recognition. It's pretty exciting to be here tonight and to win the award. I am the regional representative for Kitchener-Waterloo, and I just wanted to give a shout-out to all of our KW partners. I'm not going to list them all off because I think we're kind of reaching the end of our time, and we've got over 10 in the area. But awesome job, Waterloo Region, and keep helping us reduce packaging waste.
Congratulations to the Friendlier team. It's great to see small businesses who are prioritizing the environment and sustainability practices in their business model. Our next presentation is for Small Business of the Year Award with 1 to 10 employees, sponsored by MNP LLP. Introducing the award is Sarah Tam, partner at MNP. Presenting the award is Eric Rakeman, manager at MNP.
On behalf of MNP, we are proud to be sponsoring the Small Business of the Year Award with 1 to 10 employees. Over the past year, and even in the most challenging times, small business owners have continued to show strength, persistence, and grit. Tonight's small business nominees have demonstrated innovative and proactive leadership within their industry. They have also shown significant and measurable success while practicing good corporate citizenship and promoting community betterment. Congratulations to the following nominees: Cart to Curb, Diana's Divine Escape Mobile Spa, Deha's House of Patties Inc., Devonify, Estee Chocolates, For All Ice Cream, Future Focus, Inc., Hertzberger & Associates, Joni Studios, Reeve & Company, Inc., Roxton Industries, Inc.
Congratulations to For All Ice Cream. A measure of For All Ice Cream's success is their consistent growth since opening in May of 2017. Originally a two-person company, they grew to a six-person team with revenue of $100,000 in their first year. One small retail outlet and a half dozen wholesale accounts. By 2021, they have grown to have five full-time staff members and up to 15 additional part-time staff in the summer. They have over 40 wholesale accounts and a retail outlet in Uptown Waterloo, along with a production facility that has grown from 500 square feet to 1,300 square feet. As a community-minded small business, they demonstrate innovation and proactive leadership in several ways. All staff are competitively paid well above minimum wage, and all full-time staff are paid above the living wage for the region. They support the community by participating in fundraisers and have introduced highly visible sustainability and environment initiatives through their creation of the Ice Cream Jar Return Program. So please join me in welcoming founder and chief ice cream maker, Adjua Minta, to accept this award.
Oh my goodness, I can't believe this. Was not expecting this at all. Thank you so much to the chamber. Thank you to the community for embracing us as much as you have. So incredibly surprised for this award and recognition. I'm accepting this award definitely on behalf of both my production and service teams who work so hard to uphold all of our efforts, to uphold basically the vision that I had for this business when I first started. A huge congratulations to all the other nominees and the winners tonight. Thank you so much.
Congratulations again to For All Ice Cream. Our next presentation is for Business of the Year Award with 11-250 employees, sponsored by Miller Thompson LLP. Presenting this award is Rohit Kumar, partner with Miller Thompson LLP.
Miller Thompson LLP is proud to sponsor the Business of the Year Award with 11-50 employees. Nominees have demonstrated innovative and proactive leadership within their industry. They have also demonstrated significant measurable success while practicing good corporate citizenship and promoting community betterment. This year's award recognized a resilient organization who continues to successfully navigate a turbulent year. The nominees are Bent Kitchens and Millwork, Inc., Briarfield Gardens Retirement Residence by Rivera, Certipro Painters, Waterloo, Clean and Tidy, Inc., Diva International, Driver's Seat, Euro Reflections, H2R Business Solutions, Hunt Logistics, Macho Movers, Inc., Overlap Associates, Princess Cinemas, Simplifying Supply Chain Solutions, and The Museum.
Congratulations to Diva International. Diva International has committed to being global leaders in the menstrual cup category, as well as committing to helping people and the planet. They have created the Diva Recycles program to eliminate waste in partnership with TerraCycle. In the past year alone, their social impact program has also diverted use and waste of 3.6 million disposable menstrual products by donating over 15,000 Diva cups. Diva International has donated over $210,000 in products and $43,200 in sponsorship to Black-led and BIPOC-focused organizations. Diva International's commitment to social impact is proven through their B Corp certification and social impact program, which helps the community succeed in providing support for sustainability and menstrual equity initiatives. Joining us to accept the award is Kareem Chambers-Samey, CEO and founder of Diva International.
I'm not sure if this is working with the technology. This was extremely unexpected. Thank you so much to the Chamber of Commerce. We just live in such a fantastic community. Thank you so much, and congratulations to all the nominees tonight. I have to definitely accept this award on behalf of our incredible team at Diva International, makers of the Diva Cup, and we have been through so much over the last 3 years, as I know all of you have been as well. And it's just been such a challenging time, and so the fact that we're all still here and we can celebrate and celebrate our businesses and community and give back to our amazing community is just such an honor. Thank you so much. I don't know what else to say. Thank you very much.
Congratulations again to Diva International. Our next presentation is for Business of the Year Award with over 50 employees sponsored by University of Waterloo. Presenting the award is Marion Canning, Regional Manager, Cooperative Education with University of Waterloo.
We are proud to sponsor the Business of the Year Award with over 50 employees. Nominees have demonstrated innovative and proactive leadership within their industry. They have also demonstrated significant, measurable success while practicing good corporate citizenship and promoting community betterment. This year's nominees are Bank Kitchens and Millwork Incorporated, Friarfield Gardens Retirement Residence by Rivera, CertiPro Painters Waterloo, Clean and Tidy, Inc., Diva International, Driver's Seat, Euro Reflections, H2R Business Solutions, Hunt's Logistics, Module Movers, Inc., Overlap Associates, Princess Cinemas, Simply Supply Chain Solutions, and the Museum.
Congratulations to Grand River Hospital. Grand River Hospital played a significant role in the region's COVID response over the last 2 years. Grand River opened the region's first vaccine clinic to protect priority populations and healthcare staff right across the region, and has helped to provide over 260,000 doses. They also participated in research that has enhanced knowledge of COVID-19 and treatments and supported provincial capacity by caring for transferred patients from Ontario's hardest-hit hospitals during the third wave. Throughout the pandemic, Grand River Hospital added 127 beds to manage increased patient needs and increased virtual care by 35% in 2020. As an organization, Grand River continues to look for opportunities to support patients and enhance their community. The hospital has made innovation a priority and formalized this commitment through partnerships and support local established organizations and startups to test new and innovative health inventions and solutions in hospital settings for the benefit of everyone involved. In addition to Grand River Hospital, we would also like to thank and acknowledge all the frontline workers who contributed to bettering the community during these unprecedented times. Now, accepting the award on behalf of Grand River Hospital, please join me in welcoming President and CEO Ron Daniel.
Although I didn't expect it, there's people who are better than me that did, so wrote a couple words for me to share with you. And I probably don't actually need to look at this. I'm standing here because of almost 5,000 people who are at Grand River Hospital, from the board to the frontline staff to our foundation partners to our volunteers, who every single day come through our walls to make sure that our community gets exceptional care. And over the last 2 years, we've asked more of them than I ever thought possible. And what I've been amazed at and humbled by is their caring, their compassion, their give-it-all attitude, and their innovation. And they did that to protect us. And they did that to serve us. And we do it also knowing that many of you had to make sacrifices so that we could provide care for our community. So thank you for that. We know it hasn't been easy. And we recognize the community that we live in, a community of barn raisers, a community of innovators, a community that cares about the community and the people in it. And we feel privileged to be part of it. And we are committed to making sure that this organization and our partners in healthcare, and I'm going to call out a couple of them, St. Mary's General Hospital, Cambridge Memorial Hospital, we could not have done what we've done in the last couple of years without the partnership that we have with them. And collectively, we will deliver world-class healthcare to support healthier lives in this community, because that's what this region deserves and needs to be the world-class community we all want to be. So thank you very much.
Congratulations again to Grand River Hospital, and thank you again to all of our healthcare partners and frontline staff in the region who have worked tirelessly over the past 2 years. Our final presentation for this evening is the Michael R. Follett Community Leader of the Year Award, sponsored by Equitable Life of Canada. Presenting this award is Mark Avaria, Senior Vice President Group with Equitable Life of Canada.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. Equitable Life of Canada is a proud sponsor of the Michael R. Follett Community Leader of the Year Award. This award is a special one, as it is in recognition of a past president, a board chair of the chamber, who was a highly respected individual. Michael R. Follett is fondly remembered for his wit and his charm, as well as his dedication as an outstanding volunteer and mentor, and a passionate community leader. This award is presented to an outstanding individual who has demonstrated leadership in the development of the community by creating or facilitating significant solutions to meet community needs and inspiring others to achieve excellence.
This year's recipient is a trailblazer in the Canadian construction industry. She serves as the Grand Valley Construction Association's first female chair in 2000. Prior to being appointed president in 2006, before joining GVCA, she had over 25 years of experience in the industry after co-founding George Masonry with her husband, Doug. She's a strong advocate for bridging the gender equity gap in construction. She established the Women in Construction Group that connects the association's female workforce with leaders in the industry. Not only did she help guide GVCA into the 21st century with digital communications, but also launched members' economic procurement and business forums. She also forged strong partnerships with Conestoga College, serving on various Conestoga boards and committees, as well as spearheading fundraising initiatives. But her work and dedication go far beyond the association. She has served as a director on a variety of boards, including the Canadian Construction Association, the Council of Ontario Construction Associations, Waterloo Region Economic Development Board, University of Waterloo, Grand River Hospital Governance and Community Engagement Committee, among many others. In 2013, she was honored with the Queen's Jubilee Award, and although we can't necessarily beat the significance of that award, we are so pleased to recognize Martha George as the winner of the 2022 Michael R. Follett Community Leader of the Award. Please join me in welcoming Martha George.
I did all of it wearing heels, too. Thank you so much for this award. There are so many people that are so worthy of this award, and I just want to thank the Chamber for recognizing me. You know, I get to do what I love to do every day, and then you give me an award. I mean, how great is that? So nobody gets to do all of these things without a lot of support from families, some of which are here with us today. I have a terrific staff and a board of governors at the association that support me in all the things that I do every day. But the one person I have to thank is my husband, Doug, who introduced me to the construction industry. And we've worked together for many, many years. She's been my best teacher, my mentor, and certainly my biggest cheerleader. So congratulations to all nominees and all winners. Thank you so much for coming. So congratulations once again to you, Martha, and congratulations again to all of this evening's award recipients. Before we conclude the evening, we do have a couple of final winners to announce. Two attendees were randomly selected as our door prize winners. So $50 in Kitchener BIA downtown dollars goes to Laura Umbrio from Proof Kitchen and Lounge. And $50 in Uptown Waterloo BIA uptown dollars going to Luke Shantz from Arcadian Projects. A chamber rep will find you, connect with you, and tell you what to do next from there. I would now like to introduce Ian McLean, President and CEO of the Greater KW Chamber of Commerce, now to say a few words.
Well, thank you, Alex, and I just want to take a few moments as we wrap up tonight to congratulate all of the winners, but also the nominees, and thanks to everyone here and virtually for making the decision to join us this evening. This is our first large in-person event in over 2 years, and we're looking forward to having more with each passing day. I'll take a moment just to thank my incredible team, especially Carolyn and Mari, who have coordinated this whole evening. They manage our whole team, which this takes us 12 months, and everyone on the team to make it happen. Over 26 months, my team have done incredible things. They've provided programs and events virtually, and all have been to serve you. I'm incredibly appreciative and thankful for their work on your behalf. And finally, I'd also like to take a moment just to thank Alex. Thank you for your work as our host this evening and for the work that CTV does with us every year. It's very much appreciated. As a thank you, a donation is made in your name to the KW Humane Society. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much, Ian, for those kind words. Thank you again to all of our sponsors who made this evening possible, including our title sponsor, Cowan Insurance Group. Thank you all for being here tonight. It was a pleasure to host the first time that I had a chance hosting this event and live in person, hybrid, I guess. It's nice to see some familiar faces, some new faces, and it's so great to just highlight the local businesses we have here in Waterloo Region and highlight local success. Now, the event is not over yet. The BMO After Party starts right now with networking, entertainment, and much more. And to help kick off the After Party, I'd like to welcome Keisha Tiwari, BMO Bank of Montreal.
Thank you, Alex. What an incredible evening it is. Amazing. Thank you to the Chamber of Commerce for organizing the event. 26 months. Wow. Such a long time. It is amazing to see faces here, see smiles. It is great. I'm not going to talk a lot. I will just say congratulations to each and everyone, all the nominees, all the winners here for the Business Excellence Award tonight. Owning a business is an act of courage. You start, you grow, and then you have to manage. It's not easy. I've been a banker 10 years. And now I know how important a business is for everyone and how incredible you guys are by participating and running and spending each and every day with what you do. Thank you for making this community an amazing one, and thank you, everyone. Enjoy the after party on BMO. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, and thank you all for your continued support. We look forward to seeing you at next year's 2023 Business Excellence Awards Gala. Have a great night and enjoy the BMO After Party. Thank you.